Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Our Lady of the Lake. This morning, our presider will be your pastor, Father Peter Richards. Our readings and songs for the day can be found at the numbers that will be on the red display. The readings this morning will be at 1,100, and we will start by singing together hymn number 635, Let All Things Now Living. Please rise and join us in singing opening hymn number 635.
Let all things now living, a song of thanksgiving, to God the Creator triumphantly raise, who fashioned and made us, protected and stayed us, guides us with care to the end of our days. God's banners are o'er us, God's light goes before us, a pillar of fire shining forth in the night. Till shadows have vanished and darkness is banished, as forward we travel from light into light. God rules all the forces, the stars in their courses, and sun in its orbit obediently shine. The hills and the mountains, the rivers and fountains, the depths of the ocean proclaim God divine. We too should be voicing our love and rejoicing with glad adoration. A song let us raise till all things now living unite in thanksgiving to God in the highest. Hosanna and
in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Well, brothers and sisters, in the gospel, Jesus quotes from the prophet Isaiah as the one who has come to bring glad tidings to the poor, humanity, to set captives free, giving liberty to captives, and to let the oppressed go free. Today, we have a young child who will be given the gift that the Lord has come to bring. And that child will be baptized. And so you can think about your baptism as we go through this rite today. And Michael and Erica, as you have received your child into your family with joy, so now today we receive him into the family of God with great joy. Her, I should say. So what do you ask, what name do you give your child? Lucy Eleanor, and what do you ask of God's church for Lucy? For baptism. So in asking for baptism for your child, you're undertaking the responsibility of raising her in the faith so that keeping God's commandments, she may love the Lord and her neighbor as Christ has taught us. Do you understand this responsibility? And godparents, are you ready to help the parents of this child in their duty? Lucy, Eleanor, the Church of God receives you with great joy. In her name, I sign you with the sign of the cross of our Savior. Then after me, ask your parents and godparents to do the same. And now with the oil of catechumens, we will pray the prayer of exorcism and anoint her. Almighty and ever-living God, who sent your Son into the world to drive out from us the power of Satan, the spirit of evil, and bring the human race, rescued from darkness into the marvelous kingdom of your light, we humbly beseech you to free this child from original sin, to make her the temple of your glory, and to grant that your Holy Spirit may dwell in her, through Christ our Lord. Lucy Elner, may the strength of Christ the Savior protect you. As a sign of this, I'll anoint you now on the sternum with the oil of salvation in the same Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever. And now let's together sing Glory to God.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us, have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son we may abound in good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Nehemiah. Ezra the priest brought the law before the assembly, which consisted of men, women, and those children old enough to understand. Standing at one end of the open place that was before the water gate, he read out of the book from daybreak till midday, in the presence of the men, the women, and those children old enough to understand. And all the people listened attentively to the book of the law. Ezra the scribe stood on a wooden platform that had been made for the occasion. He opened the scroll so that all the people might see it, for he was standing higher up than any of the people. And as he opened it, all the people rose. Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God, and all the people, their hands raised high, answered, "Amen, amen." Then they bowed down and prostrated themselves before the Lord, their faces to the ground. Ezra read plainly from the book of the law of God, interpreting it so that all could understand what was read. Then Nehemiah, that is, his excellency, and Ezra the priest scribe, and the Levites who were instructing the people, said to all the people, "Today is holy to the Lord your God. Do not be sad and do not weep." For all the people were weeping as they heard the words of the law. He said further, "Go, eat rich foods and drink sweet drinks, and allot portions to those who had nothing prepared, for today is holy to the Lord our God. Do not be saddened this day, for rejoicing in the Lord must be your strength." The word of the Lord.
Of everlasting life. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The Lord's rule is to be trusted. The simple find wisdom. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. The fear of the Lord is holy, abiding forever. The decrees of the Lord are true, all of them just. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. The precepts of the Lord are right, they gladden the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, giving light to the eye. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. They are worth more than gold, than the finest gold, sweeter than honey, the honey from the comb. Lord, you have the words of everlasting
life. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, as a body is one, though it has many parts, and all the parts of the body, though many, are one body, so also is Christ. For in one spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of the one spirit. Now the body is not a single part, but many. If a foot should say, but I'm not a hand, and I do not belong to the body, it does not for this reason belong any less to the body. Or if an ear should say, because I'm not an eye, I do not belong to the body, it does not for this reason belong any less to the body. If the whole body were an eye, where would hearing be? If the whole body were hearing, where would the sense of smell be? But as it is, God placed the parts, each one of them, in the body as he intended. If they were all one part, where would the body be? But as it is, there are many parts, yet one body. The eye cannot say to the hand, I do not need you, nor the head to the feet, I do not need you. Indeed, the parts of the body that seem to be weaker are all the more necessary, and those parts of the body that we consider less honorable, we surround with great honor, and our less presentable parts are treated with greater propriety, whereas our more presentable parts do not need this. But God has so constructed the body as to give greater honor to a part that is without it, so that there may be no division in the body, but that the parts may have the same concern for one another. If one part suffers, all parts suffer with it. If one part is honored, all the parts share its joy. Now you are Christ's body, and individually parts of it. Some people God has designated in the church to be, first apostles, second prophets, third teachers, then mighty deeds, then gifts of healing, assistance, administration, and varieties of tongues. Are all apostles? Are all prophets? Are all teachers? Do all work mighty deeds? Do all have gifts of healing? Do all speak in tongues? Do all interpret? The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah, 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 the Lord sent me to bring glad tidings to the poor and to proclaim liberty to the captives. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Since many have undertaken to compile a narrative of the events that have been fulfilled among us, just as those who were witnesses from the beginning and ministers of the word have handed them down to us, I too have decided, after investigating everything accurately anew, to write it down in an orderly sequence for you, most excellent Theophilus, so that you may realize the certainty of the teachings you have received. Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit, and news of him spread throughout the whole region. He taught in their synagogues and was praised by all. He came to Nazareth, where he had grown up, and went according to his custom into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He stood up to read and was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord. Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently at him. He said to them, "Today this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." The Gospel of the Lord. So this week we'll do the fourth part of the Kerygma series. And I'll title it A Response. So what do you give to somebody who saves your life, who saves you from death? A couple weeks ago, I was returning on a flight from vacation. I won't tell you where because you might be jealous. Got to watch a movie, Saving Private Ryan. I think some movies these days can be modern day parables, and this one had a really good message. Most of the movie, Saving Private Ryan, right? And most of the movie is a flashback, and it's begun with the elderly Private Ryan telling about it. So just after the Allies landed on Normandy Beach in World War II, an American chief of staff finds out that three of the four Ryan brothers had already died in battle. So he wants to save the last one for his family, bring him back out of war. So he sends out orders to Army Captain Miller and a squad of soldiers to find him and bring him back. They have a hard time finding him for a number of reasons, but finally at the end of the movie they find him, and he won't leave his post. And so the squad stays and fights with him. But in the battle, the many of the squad dies, and Captain Miller is dying at the end on the bridge they're defending. And Private Ryan comes to him, at which point Captain Miller barely gets out, "Earn this." And he says it again, "Earn this." And then he breathes his last. And then the end of the movie is the elderly Private Ryan, James Ryan, with his family, goes to visit the grave of Captain Miller, and is talking to the cross, crouching down, and it's the cross that marks Captain Miller's grave. And he says, "Every day I think about what you said to me on that bridge. I've tried to live my life the best I could. I hope that is enough. I hope that at least in your eyes, I have earned what all of you have done for me." Now, Captain Miller urged Ryan to make his life worth the loss of his own and those of the other soldiers. It's a powerful image. And as it relates to our faith, we don't earn God's love and what he does for us. We don't earn who God is. God is who he is, and he's done what he's done out of his own love and generosity. We don't strive to please God so that he will accept us and love us. That's backwards. He already does. He already loves us. But our faith is a response to that. Our faith is a response. What do you give someone who is the creator of a universe that's 46 billion light years across? He's created everything we can see and everything we can't see. He made the human race. He made you and me out of love, to be loved, to love for all eternity. He became incarnate. He suffered, died a horrible, humiliating death, rose from the dead, rescued me and you freed us, liberated us from the power of eternal death, sin, the devil, and his demons. What do we give him? I'm going to pause for 15 seconds, and if you are so inclined, to pray for three graces today and maybe out throughout this week. To ask God for the grace of worship of him and praise and thanksgiving and surrendering, the gift of surrender to him. Human beings were made for greatness, particularly in love, in our relationships, our relationship to God and to others. And when we're in a relationship with someone, who they are and what they do for us begs a response. God desires a personal response from us to all that he is and he has done for us. And that response can reorient the whole of our life and orient the whole of our life. And the first part of our response to God for who he is and saving us from death is to give him what is his due. That's justice, to be just to God. And that's what justice means, is to give another what is their due. And the first thing that God is due is worship. Worship can be defined as showing honor, reverence, or devotion. Worshiping God for who he is, or adoration. No one and nothing deserves the honor, reverence, and devotion that God deserves. Yet how often does our culture, and I include myself in this too. By the way, whenever I preach, I'm also preaching to myself. How often do we give other things or people more worship than we give God? We give more reverence or devotion. Political figures, famous people, work, power, etc., etc. And how often do we not prioritize worshiping God? Praise and thanksgiving. Again, in justice, no one deserves more of this than God. And when we praise and thank God, it's for what he has done for us. The question is, how do we do that? Well, in prayer, first of all, besides our worship, praise, and thanksgiving at Mass, in personal prayer. And this can be just using the words that we would use when we thank or we praise someone else, another person. We can praise and thank God for what he's done for us and what he does for us. And a good way to learn how to praise God is to read the Psalms. That's the way of God's, that book of Psalms is a way for God to teach us how to pray, how to praise and thank him. All the Psalms end in thanks and praise. Some of them are, that's all they are, is praise and thanksgiving to God, like Psalm 145 or 103, 16, 62. And then, lastly, a just response to God, who God is and what he does for us is surrender to him. Another word for that is faith. Giving our faith to God. We do all three of these things, worship, praise, thanksgiving, and surrender to someone. Everyone does that, to someone or something. That's like the old Bob Dylan song. You got to serve somebody. I'm very tempted to try to imitate him. How does it go? It starts out, You might be an ambassador to England or France. You might be a clerk, a retail clerk that sells t-shirts and pants. That, I made that up. But you got to serve somebody. It may be the devil, or it may be the Lord, but you got to serve somebody. And you could add, you know, to the devil or to the Lord, also self. But surrender or faith is due to Jesus. Another way to think about faith is entrusting our life to the Lord. And faith isn't just an intellectual proposition to which we say, oh yeah, I believe in God. Or I believe that God exists. That's not faith. Even the devil believes God exists. He knows God is there. Faith is first of all a personal response to God that we make individually. Faith is not blind. It's simply another way of knowing. It's surrendering our whole life, all day and every day, to the Lord, our intellect, our will, our emotions, relationships, work, family, recreation, responsibilities. St. Paul's letter to Corinthians says this, "And he died for all, that those who live might live no longer for themselves, but for him who for their sake died and was raised." To live for Jesus, to live for God. Another way of describing faith is to bring into conformity everything within the sphere of my influence to the Father's plan. And lastly, another way of saying it is God's work in me, to which I respond. So I'm going to end in a few moments with a prayer. And I invite you in that, or in your own way, to surrender in faith to God, and to commit to worship and to praise and thank him. Good time to do that is at communion too. Because when we come to communion, we're surrendering to the Lord and we're receiving him into our hearts and into our minds and to our whole being. And you might be doing this for the first time, or it might be a recommitment. And it might be a time, if you haven't been baptized or missing some of the sacraments, to think about finding out what you'll need to do in order to do that, to receive those sacraments and receive the sacrament of reconciliation as well. So I'll say the prayer to end today. Lord, I worship you for who you are. The good Father, creator of a universe that's 46 billion years, light years across. You've created this beautiful planet in which we live, and every human being on it that has ever been conceived or will be conceived. I thank you and praise you for my being in your image and likeness, and for rescuing me, liberating me from the death and sin and the devil and his demon's power, and for strengthening me to fight against these with your power. And I surrender my life to you today and every day. I commit to remember you every day and who you are, and what you've done for me. And I ask you, your help, to bring everything in the sphere of my influence, including myself, into conformity with your loving plan. Amen. Let's together profess our faith in God. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. I ask you now to be seated, and except for our family and the godparents. So I forgot about doing the questions for your baptismal profession of faith. We all said the profession of faith together, so I won't make you do it again, okay? Michael and Erica, is it your will that Lucy Eleanor should receive baptism in the faith of the church, which we have professed with you? Okay. And so, if you want to place her head over the baptismal font. Lucy Eleanor, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Yeah. It's okay. There we go. Lucy, Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, has freed you from sin, given you new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and joined you to his holy people. All of that, and this gift we're talking about in the homily of Jesus rescuing us from all of these things, that's what she just received, giving her the grace and power, and he anoints you with the chrism of salvation, so that you may remain as a member of Christ, priest, prophet, and king unto eternal life. Amen. So we anoint her now on the crown of her head. As priests in the Old Testament, in the ancient world, were anointed priest, prophet, and king, we anoint her. Lucy, you have become a new creation and have clothed yourself in Christ. See in the white garment that you wear a sign of to you of your Christian dignity. With your family and friends to help you by word and example, bring it unstained into eternal life. And one of the godparents can light the candle from the Easter candle. Receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly so that your child, enlightened by Christ, may walk always as a child of the light. Persevering in the faith, may run to meet the Lord Jesus when he comes with all the saints in the heavenly courts. Now we pray the Ephatha prayer, and I'll touch her ears and her mouth after I pray this. May the Lord Jesus, who made the deaf hear and the mute speak, grant that you may soon receive his word with your ears and profess the faith with your lips to the glory and great praise of God the Father. Lucy Eleanor, baptized in Christ, you are clothed with Christ. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. Let's welcome the newest member of our faith, Lewis Eleanor, Lucy. Okay. Please now stand and we'll offer our prayers of petition to the Lord.
For Pope Francis and all our church leaders, that the Spirit of the Lord may be upon them as they fervently proclaim the kingdom of God. We pray to the Lord. For government leaders around the world, that they would be guided by the fear of the Lord and make a true commitment to work for justice and peace for all people. We pray to the Lord. For people and nations suffering from famine, poverty, and terrorism, that they may find the relief they need. We pray to the Lord. For this parish community, that we may attentively listen to the word of God as it is spoken and share in the body of Christ at the Eucharistic table. We pray to the Lord. For the newly baptized, especially Lucy Rolfs, that she may continue to grow in the graces of this sacrament, we pray to the Lord. For our brothers and sisters who may be suffering in any way, that God may grant them healing and peace, we pray to the Lord. For those who have gone before us and all who mourn for them, that they may find rest in God's kingdom in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
I'd like to also pray on this weekend for restoration of legal right to life for all human beings from conception to natural death, for the conversion of those who promote abortion and perform abortions. We pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness. Grant these prayers, for we ask them through Christ our Lord.
One body, one Lord of all, one cup of blessing which we bless, and we, though many, throughout the earth, we are one body. Gentile or Jew, servant or free, woman or man, no more. One bread, one body, one Lord of all, one cup of blessing which we bless.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just,
our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Claim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Let us pray with longing for the coming of the kingdom. In the words our Savior taught us, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Now offer one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you.
are many parts. We are all one body, and the gifts we have, we are given to share. May the Spirit of love make us one indeed, one the love that we share, one our hope in despair. One the cross that we bear. God of all, we look to you. We would be your servants true. Let us be your love to all the world. We are many parts. We are all one body. And the gifts we have, we are given to share. May the Spirit of love make us one indeed, one the love that we share, one our hope in despair, one the cross that we bear. So my pain is pain for you, in your joy is my joy too, all is brought together in the Lord. We are many parts, we are all one body, and the gifts we of love make us one indeed, one the love that we share, one our hope in despair, one the cross that we bear. All you seekers, great and small, seek the greatest gift of all. If you love, then you will know the Lord. We are many parts. We are all one body. And the gifts we have, we are given to share. May the Spirit of us one indeed, one the love that we share, one our hope in despair, one the cross that we foundation, you saints of the Lord, is laid for your faith in Christ Jesus the Word. What more can God say than to you has been said, to you for refuge to Jesus have fled. Fear not, I am with you, dismayed, for I am your God and will still give you aid. I'll strengthen you, help you, and and cause you to stand, upheld by my righteous, omnipotent hand. When through the deep waters I call you to go, the rivers of woe shall not you overflow, for I will be with you, your troubles to bless, and sanctify you, your deepest distress. The soul that on Jesus still leans for repose, I will not desert to its foes. That soul, though all hell should endeavor to shake, I'll never, no, never, no, never
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in your gift through Christ our Lord.
Amen. You're welcome to take away or take home any of the white poinsettias in the back of the church after Mass. And I know it's cold. They have some plastic bags to put them in. Next Sunday, in support of Catholic School Week, the CCW and Knights of Columbus will be serving a light breakfast, including donuts. A free will offering to support our school will be taken. Donations will help support the 7th and 8th graders traveling to Wolf Ridge in February. And then stop by the gathering mass or gathering space after Mass today to help support the school by purchasing a $5 raffle ticket. All proceeds go to the school, and every ticket purchased will be entered into a drawing. Please see the flyer in the bulletin for more details.
And I just want to make a plea for the mass ministries, and we need it for all of them, but particularly the mass ministries, if you are willing to be a reader or a sacristan, usher, server. And you don't have to be in sixth grade to be a server. You can be older, like Julia is. But we could really use more of these, a lot of people, so that because a lot of the times it's the same people who have to be responsible and step in. So the more the merrier. So next week we're not going to have you sign up, but the week after that, there'll be an opportunity to sign up for these mass ministries afterwards to give you some time to think and pray about it. Have a great day. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Stars and angels sing. forest, vale, and mountain, flowery meadow, flashing sea, chanting bird and flowing fountain, sound their praise.